In this session, we are going to discuss about the types of cell. In that, the first one is the empty cell. What is meant by the empty cell? The cell which does not contain any elements, we call it as an empty cell. And this empty cell is denoted by like this, because it does not contain any elements, just we denote it like this. And this empty cell we call it as an null cell or void cell. We can call it in any of the way. We call it as an empty cell, null cell or void cell, and it is represented by this symbol. Or you can denote like this also. This all indicates the empty set. What is meant by the empty set? The set does not contain any elements, we call it as an empty set. Let us consider an example. The set of x such that 1 less than x less than 2, and here x is a natural number. Okay, here if you consider this set here, you can observe that you need to write this one in the roster form. If you want to write this set in the roster form, you have to write what are the elements that are present in this set. Here, what this set indicates that here you need to write what are the elements that lies between 1 and 2. Here, what we need to write, you have to write the elements that lies between 1 and 2, and you have to write the natural numbers. You know that the natural numbers will start from 1, 2, and 1 you will get after 2, but in between these two numbers there will be no number. So in this you can observe that no elements will be there in this set. So we have to represent this set as an empty set. So what we can say here, this set is an empty set. What is empty set? If the set does not contain any elements, that we call it as an empty set. Let us see one more example for this. Here consider the example, write the set of months that contains greater than 35 days. Let us consider this set. You need to write what are the months that is having more than 35 days. You know that there is no month that is having more than 35 days. In a month, there will be 30 or 31, and in February it may be 28 or 29 based upon the leap year, but you did not get the month that contains more than 35 days. So here in this, no element is present in this set, so we can say that it is an empty set. Now consider here the next type of set, which is the singleton set. So what is meant by the empty set? If the set does not contain any elements, we call it as an empty set. And this empty set we call it as a void set or the null set, and it is denoted by the symbol, you call it as unified, or this one is empty set. Now see the next type of set, which is a singleton set. What is singleton set? Singleton set means if the set contains only one element, we call it as a singleton set. Let us consider one example. The set of even prime numbers. You need to write what are the elements that are present in this set. So here, you know that what is an even prime number? You know that only one prime number exists, which is even, that is 2. Here, you can observe that in this set only one element is present. So we can say that it is a singleton set. What is meant by the singleton set? If the set contains only one element, we call it as a singleton set. So if you take, you can consider this as an example. If you want to find the set of even prime numbers, you know that in the prime numbers only 2 is the even number. So we can say that it is a singleton set. Now consider one more example. The set of x such that 0 less than or equal to x less than 1. Here x is a whole number. Let us consider this set here. Here we need to write what are the elements that lies between 0 and 1. Between 0 and 1, what are the elements that lies, we need to write it. So here, write how many elements that are present in between 0 and 1. You know that the whole number starts from 0 and 1. In between these two numbers, no element will be present. And here, we have included here equality symbol. That means here you can include here 0. So what are the element that is present here? 0. Since here equality symbol is not there, you should not consider 1. Now here, what are the elements that are present in this set? 0 is the one element that are present in this set. So we can say that it is a singleton set because here only one element is present. Now see the next one, which is the universal set. So what is meant by the empty set? If the set does not contain any elements, we call it as an empty set. And what is meant by the singleton set? If the set contains only one element, we call it as a singleton set. And the next one is the universal set. And this universal set is denoted by the letter mu. We call it as a mu. And we denote it like this. This one we call it as a mu. And what is meant by the universal set? The set, the name itself says, what is meant by the universal set? The set that contains everything, we call it as a universal set. So, what we can say here, the set that contains everything, we call it as a universal set. And this universal set are denoted by the letter mu. And after that, let us consider one example to understand what is meant by the universal set. Let us consider few sets here. A is equal to the set of the students. Set of students of class 10A. And let us consider one more set, which is C, the set of the students of class 10B. And here, let us consider one more set, the set of the students of class 10C. Let us consider these sets here. Here, what will be the universal set? This universal set you can represent as mu, or you can denote it as mu. Here, how do you write the universal set, which is nothing but the set of the students of class 10? Right? This is the universal set. It is all these sets are present. So, what is meant by the universal set? A set that contains everything. We call it as a universal set. And you can observe that these are the sets that are present in this universal set. And we can represent this universal set in the form of the rectangle. If you want to represent the representation of sets in the form of the diagram, we call it as a Venn diagram. What we call those diagrams, we call it as a Venn diagrams. What is Venn diagrams? Representation of the sets in the form of the figures, we call it as a Venn diagrams. If you want to represent universal set, you have to represent that one in the form of the rectangle. And in this, at the end of the right side, represent, write it as mu. It indicates that it is a universal set. In the universal set, what it belongs, all the students of class 10 is belonging to this set. And in this, we got many sets here. This is the, let us consider these three sets here. Here, you can take this set as the set of the students of class 10A. And here, you can take the set of the students of class 10B. And you can take here the set of the students of class 10C. That means there are three sections in the class 10, which is 10A, 10B and 10C. All these together, we call it as a universal set. Because here, all are 10th class students, but we have separated that one in the form of the sections 10A, 10B and 10C. This is nothing but the representation of the universal sets. So what is meant by the universal set? The set that contains everything, we call it as a universal set. Now, see the subset and sets. Or you can consider one more example for the universal set. Let us consider the universal set as the set of natural numbers. In that, you can consider the sets which is the set of even numbers and the set of odd numbers. and here this set as B, which is the set of the odd numbers, and 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and all these together we represented in a universal set. Like this you can represent in the form of the Venn diagram. Venn diagram is nothing but representation of the sets in the form of the diagrams, we call it as a Venn diagram. Now see the next one, which is subset. Now we are going to define about the subset and the proper subset. First define about the subset. What is meant by the subset? So before going to discuss this one, let us consider few examples here. Let us consider the set A as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And consider the set B, which contains 2 and 3. Here you can observe that here 2 is present, here also 2 is present. Here 3 is there, here also 3 is there. So what we can say here, B is a part of A, right? Here this part is existing in this set. So what we can say here, B is a part of A. In the mathematical world, we call this part as a subset. So here, what we can say here, B is a subset of A. Because here, from this what we can conclude here, every element of B is also present in A. So we can say that B is a subset of A. What is meant by the subset here? If you consider two sets A and B, here you can observe that here B is a part of A, because all the elements in B are also present in the set A. So we can say that B is a part of A, and in the mathematical words we call it as B is a subset of A. Now here this one we denote by the symbol this one. This indicates this is the symbol for the subset, and we call it as B is subset of A. Now here consider this thing, what we got it here, B is subset of A. That means every element of A must also be present in the set A. Here write it, what is meant by the subset here. Every element of B must be present in every element of A. That means here what we can observe here, let us consider here 2. You know that 2 belongs to B, right? Because 2 is an element of B. From this what we can conclude here, 2 is also belongs to A, because this 2 element is also present in A. So we can say that here if this 2 is present in both B and A, we can say that B is a subset of A. That means every element of B must be present in every element of A. This one we call it as a subset. Now how do you represent in the form of the Venn diagram? This one. Here first you need to draw the universal set and mark it as U, mu, and after that you need to represent the set A. Right here these sets are represented in the form of the circles, and what are the elements presented here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? These are the elements that are present in the set A. Now you need to represent the set B, which contains 2 entries. You know that B is a part of B, B is a part of A, and B is a subset of A. How do you represent? Just you need to represent here one more circle. You know that 2 entries are present. So write it here B, and what are the remaining elements left out here? 1, 4 and 5. This is the represent of B subset of A. That means every element of B is also present in every element of A. That we call it as a subset. Like this we have to represent in the form of the Venn diagrams. Now see here one more example. What we have told, what is meant by subset? Every element of B must be present in every element of A. That we call it as a subset. Now consider one more set here. Let us consider A is equal to 4, 5, 6. And let us consider one more set, which is again 4, 5, 6. Here you can observe that what is the definition of the subset? Every element of A must be present in every element of B. Here you can observe that 4 is present here and 4 is also there. Here 5 is there, there also 5 is there, here 6 is there, here also 6 is there. From this you can say here every element of A is also present in every element of B. So we can say that here A is subset of B. Right? Because every element of A is also present in this set, so we can say that A is subset of B. From this, what we can conclude? Every set is a subset of itself. Suppose consider here the same set here, A is equal to 4, 5, 6, and consider here one more set which is A is equal to 4, 5, 6. You know that these elements are present in the set A. From this, we can say that A is subset of A. Every element is a subset of itself. This one is very important bit. Every element is a subset of itself. If you consider the set B, B is subset of B. Right? Now, consider the definition of proper subset. There is some small difference in between the subset and the proper subset. Here the next one is the proper subset. What the proper subset says here, if you consider the set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, let us consider the set B as 4 and 5. Here you can observe that B is a subset of A because every element of B is present in the set A. So we can say that here B is a subset of A, and just now only we discussed this is a symbol for subset. Here what is meant by the proper subset is nothing but there should be at least one element that is present in the set A, but it should not be present in the set B. So here you can observe that here 3 is present in the set A, but 3 does not exist in the set B. So we can say that B is a proper subset of A. This is the meaning of proper subset, or otherwise you can get clarification here. B is subset of A. This means that B is subset of A and B is equal to A. These two conditions are satisfied here. Right? B is proper subset of A and B is equal to A. If these two conditions are satisfied, you can say that B is subset of A. And what is meant by B is proper subset of A? That means here B does not equal to A. Here you can observe that this B does not equal to A because the elements that are present in the set A is not equal to the elements that are present in the set B. From this we can conclude here B is not equal to A. So what is meant by the proper subset? Every element of B must be present in the set A, but there should be at least one element in set A that should not exist in the set B. Now consider one more example of the proper subset. Here consider the set, here the set of alls, which is, you know that it is A, E, I, O, U. And now consider the set of alphabets. Here let us consider the set as A. You know that what are the alphabets A, B, C, D and so on, and last you will get Z. These are the set of the alphabets. Here you can observe that every element of B is also present in the set A, because here A will exist, here also you will get A, here E is there, here also you will get E. And you know that A, E, I, O, U, these all elements are present in the set A. So we can say that here B is subset of A, because every element of B is also present in the set A. But what is meant by the proper subset here? That means there should be at least one element that should be present in A, but it should not exist in the set B. Here you can observe that here B is there, here B is not there. So we can say that B is proper subset of A. This is the definition of the proper subset. What is meant by the proper subset? Every element of A, B must exist in the set B, but there should be at least one element in set A that should not be exist in the set B. This is the proper subset. Next, we are going to discuss about the union of sets. And after that we are going to discuss about the intersection of the sets. What is meant by the union of sets? Union of sets means you need to write all the elements that are present in the sets. Let us consider here the set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And let us consider one more set which is B is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. Now you need to write A union B. That means union of set means you need to write A union B, and this union is denoted by the symbol this one. This U indicates that this union, and that means A union B means you need to write all the elements that are present in the set B. That 1 and 2 and then 3, 4, 5 and after 6 and after 7. These are the elements that are present in both of these sets. So we have represented this one as A union B. What is A union B? You need to write all the elements that are present in both the sets. This one we call it as an A union B. Now here this one we can represent in the form of the Venn diagram like this. Here suppose you have given the universal set as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let us suppose they have given this is the universal set and you know that the universal set are denoted by the symbol mu and we need to represent it here how many sets A and B. So here draw two circles here. This is one circle and this is one circle. Why we have joined these two circles we will come to know in a few seconds here. Let us represent this one as A and this set as B. Now you need to write what are the elements that are present in the set A in this circle and you have to write the elements that are present in B you have to write in this circle. Now if you want to write this one first you need to know what are the common elements that are present in the these two sets. Here you can observe that what are the common elements that are present here. Here 4 is there, here also 4 is there. Here 5 is there, here also 5 is there. These are the common elements that are present in between these two sets. So you have to represent these common elements and the common area. Here you can observe that these two circles are intersecting here at a common area. You know that this is the common area. These two circles are intersecting. So you need to represent these two elements in this area, which is 4 and 5. Right? Because these are the elements that are present in common here. Now you can write the remaining elements. What are left in the set A? What are the left here? 1, 2, 3. So write it here. 1, 2, 3. Now in the set B, we have written already 5, 4 and 5. What we need to represent here? 6 and 7. 6 and 7. This is the union. So here write it here. A union B. If you want to shade it, what is the shaded part here? This is the total part. Right? What is A union B? A union B